Hello friends, today I am going to discuss about basics of X-ray diffraction, absorption and fluorescence under X-ray spectroscopy. As you know, X-ray is a electromagnetic radiation and the wavelength of X-ray is 0.01 to 10 nanometer. This video is sponsored by GPAD Discussion Center. Visit JDC for GPAD.com for details about GPAD, NIPER, Drugs Inspector and Pharmacist exams. Use Dr. Pushpendra Classes coupon code, that is PK25, and get 25% discount in all online test series of GDC4GPAD.com. So, wavelength of X-ray is 0.01 to 10 nanometer, or we can say 0.1 to 100 angstrom. And for analytical purpose, the wavelength is 0.07 to 0.2 nanometer, or we can say 0.7 to 2 angstrom. So, this wavelength is most useful for analytical purpose or for X-ray spectroscopy. As its name suggests, in X-ray spectroscopy, we are using X-ray as a radiation source. So let's understand the mechanism of X-ray spectroscopy by using a diagrammatic representation. So this is the diagrammatic representation to understand the mechanism of X-ray spectroscopy. Here you can see that we are having sample. So this sample will have certain structure or certain crystalline structure. And here this is incident X-rays. When this incident X-rays will pass through the sample, then these rays or this radiation will be converted into three types of radiation. One is transmitted radiation, one is diffracted radiation, and one is fluorescence radiation. Now coming to the first one, which is transmitted radiation. So how you will calculate absorbed radiation from this transmitted radiation? Here you can see that incident X-rays are coming and it will be passed through this sample. So sample will absorb some radiation and that will be known as absorbed radiation. And when we are using incident radiation minus transmitted radiation, then we will know the value of absorbed radiation. So simply our sample is absorbing some radiation and that is known as absorbed radiation. Now coming to the second type of radiation, that is diffracted radiation. So when these X-rays will go through the sample, then sample will diffract the radiation in different directions according to the atoms present in that particular sample. So here some radiation are diffracted here, some are diffracted here. This diffraction is totally dependent on the atoms present in that particular sample. So this type of radiation is known as diffracted radiation. Now coming to the third one, that is fluorescence radiation. So when this incident radiation will go through the sample, then some atoms of this sample will absorb that radiation and the electrons of those atoms will go to the excited state, and when it will coming back to the ground state, they will emit some radiation and the wavelength of those radiation will be longer than the actual incident radiation. In that case, those emitted radiation will be known as fluorescence radiation. So based on these three radiations, X-ray spectroscopy is categorized into three categories. First one is X-ray diffraction, second one is X-ray absorption, and the third one is X-ray fluorescence spectroscopy. Now coming to the first one, that is X-ray diffraction, or also known as XRD. So these X-ray diffraction methods, or XRD, are based on the scattering of X-ray by crystals. So here this is the crystals, and this crystal is scattering this incident X-ray like this. So by using this XRD method, analyst can easily identify the crystal structure of any solid sample with high degree of specificity and accuracy. This XRD method is extremely important as compared to this X-ray absorption and X-ray fluorescence. It means it is most commonly used methods under X-ray spectroscopy. So these are some basics about XRD or X-ray diffraction. In my upcoming videos, I will discuss the complete details about this X-ray diffraction techniques. Now coming to the second one, that is X-ray absorption. So this X-ray absorption method is similar to the absorption methods in other regions of electromagnetic spectra like UV visible spectroscopy, infrared spectroscopy, etc. And as it is absorbing the X-ray radiation, so it will give the information about the absorbing material or the sample. In this X-ray absorption method, a beam of X-ray is passed through the sample, and the fraction of X-ray photons absorbed is considered to be a measure of concentration of the sample. It means this is the X-ray radiation, it will pass through this sample. So this sample will absorb some photons from these X-rays, and that number of photons will be equal to, or that will be used for measurement of concentration of this sample. And as compared to other X-ray methods, this X-ray absorption method is least used. So as this method is least used as compared to other X-ray methods like X-ray diffraction and X-ray fluorescence, so it is used only to detect imperfection in the internal structure of the sample, elemental analysis, thickness measurements, etc. So this is the details about X-ray absorption. Now coming to the third one, which is fluorescence radiation related, and that is X-ray fluorescence method or X-ray emission method. So in this X-ray fluorescence or X-ray emission method, this incident radiation will go towards the sample, and the electrons present in the atoms of this sample will go to the excited state from ground state by absorbing the energy present in these X-rays. And when it will come from excited state to ground state, then that electrons will emit some radiation, some absorbed radiation, and the wavelength of those radiation will be higher than the absorbed radiation. And those radiation is known as a fluorescence radiation. So this fluorescence radiation is actually generated by this sample, and the intensity of this fluorescent radiation is measured in this X-ray fluorescence or emission fluorescence spectroscopy. So in this X-ray fluorescence or X-ray emission method, X-rays are generated within the sample, as I have already discussed, and by measuring the wavelength and the intensity of that generated radiations, analyst can perform qualitative as well as quantitative analysis. And all these three X-ray spectroscopic methods are non-destructive methods. So these are the basic details about X-ray diffraction, X-ray absorption, and X-ray fluorescence. Now in my upcoming videos, I will discuss about production of X-rays and general theory. Thank you.